Hello and welcome to this edition of The Market Share. I'm Paul Gifford, Chief Investment Officer at First Source Bank. Joining me today is Pete Cahill, one of our Senior Portfolio Managers. Pete, we talk a lot about how interest rates and corporate earnings really drive markets. Today I'd like to talk mostly about corporate earnings. So why are corporate earnings so important?
Well, Paul, I think I'll answer that in the manner of, what is a company truly worth? What a company is worth is it's worth its future earnings, or the cash flow that's distributed over the life of the business. I'd like you to take a look at our first graphic that depicts the relationship between stock prices and earnings. The time period here is the last 10 years. The terracotta line are stock prices. The green line are profits. And I'll make an observation. Over the long term, as go earnings, as go stocks. But over the short term, stocks and earnings tend to and often do go in different directions. Now, there's many reasons for that, but the chief reasons are wildly unpredictable. So at First Source, we focus on the long term and stay away from the short term. And as it relates to the long term and earnings really, really matter.
Well, I totally agree. We do focus on the long term. That does not get us away from having to pay attention to the here and now with what's going on with earnings. As this video is being produced, we're about a week away from getting our first corporate earnings. So Pete, why don't we give our audience a little bit of a preview on third quarter earnings?
Okay, so you said audience, at the risk of sounding like a reality TV show host, this may be the most dramatic earnings season in memory. The market is expecting earnings to decline by 0.1%, which if that occurs, it'll be the fourth quarter in a row that that's happened. Now, on the other hand, the last several earnings seasons have been better than feared. And if that trend were to continue this quarter, could have positive earnings growth. And in this environment, with all the economic uncertainties, that would be quite the feat. So to preview earnings season, we take a look at this graphic right here. This graph shows the 11 economic sectors and what the expectations are for earnings growth. And you can see the vast majority of these sectors are expected to have positive earnings growth. In fact, the number is 8 out of 11. Next place I'd have you look is to the far right. Energy sector is expected to have the most challenged earnings season with earnings down 50%. The reason for that, the price of oil this past quarter is roughly $10 lower than it was the year before. In fact, if we could take energy out of the math, stock market earnings would be up, expected to be up 5% this quarter. Now, let's go to the other side of the page and look at communication services and consumer discretionary. They're expected to have earnings growth of 50 and 20% respectively. Now, two of the names or companies that stand out in those sectors are Amazon and Facebook. And both companies are expected to have more than 100% earnings growth. And you might say, wow, how is that possible? One of the things we love about our economic system is that corporate management teams are held to account. If underlying market conditions would cause a company to have to adapt and change direction, these two companies embody that. Late last year, the market grew concerned about spending issues with both these companies, pressured the stock prices. Management team heard that loud and clear, course corrected, and if they both deliver 100% plus earnings, it's going to be because expense control. So earnings season is on tap. Maybe by the time you see this, it's started. It's sure to be dramatic, and we'll stay tuned to it.
Well, the good thing about the upcoming season, Pete, is it's never dull. You have daily earnings, so we have daily news and things to talk about. If this is your first time watching a Market Share video, we encourage you to subscribe at firstsource.com. And if you like the video, please share that with your friends and family as well. And as always, thank you for the opportunity to serve you and your family, and have a great day.